This lesson will cover two ways to clone a repository using GitKraken Client. Cloning is one of the most fundamental actions you'll be using with GitKraken Client, next to, say, opening a repo you already have on your machine. So before I show you how to do that in GitKraken Client, let me just browse over to a test repo that I'll be using to demonstrate the first example. And this is GitHub. I'm going to grab the clone URL from this repository. Multiple services have a similar navigation. So if you're on Bitbucket, GitLab, there's usually a place to clone to grab the copy, the clone URL to your clipboard. So I'm going to copy the HTTPS for this example. You could use SSH as well, but for this example, let's just do HTTPS. And then let me open GitKraken Client. So here I have GitKraken Client. And I'll show you two ways that you can navigate to the clone operation. So first, if you're in a new tab, this is what appears when you click this plus icon, and you'll have access to all of these actions. It may look a little different depending on when you're watching this video, but you should see an option to clone a repo. So you can click on that option, and then you'll be presented with the various the methods that I'll be talking about for cloning. You can always access this menu. So I clicked X here because you can always access this menu by clicking this folder icon. In the top left corner, it's the repo management window. Again, you'll be presented with open clone init. You can access the clone option right here, and that should be available no matter where you are in the application. Okay, so for this first method, we're gonna clone with a URL, and I have that URL on my clipboard. I can paste it in, and the only thing to check here is that make sure that the destination matches where you wish to clone the repository. If this doesn't look correct, just browse to whichever folder or directory you wish to clone your repository to. You can also change the name of the repo just by typing into the full path field right here. By default, it'll just use the repo name from the clone URL. So in this case, it's LFS PMM test. All right, so I'm gonna hit clone this repository. We're cloning the repo straight from GitHub over HTTPS. Looks like it's going through. Shouldn't take too much longer now. Okay, when you clone a repo, GitKraken Client will ask you if you wish to open it. In my case, I wish to say yes. If you say okay, it'll just dismiss this prompt and you'll be dropped back to wherever, whatever screen you have open. I'm gonna hit open now. And you should see, let's see, I don't think that is something we need to worry about. Oh, it's an LFS repo. Well, there you go. So you should see your repo open with the graph. I'll say no. You probably don't have LFS on your repository, but we have demonstrated how you can clone a repo using the clone URL option. I will now show you the second method for cloning a repository. You can probably already guess where I'm gonna go. So I'm gonna click on the repository management folder here in the top left corner, go back to clone. And sure enough, yes, you can use any of these integrations to clone repos, remote repositories on these hosting services. If you don't have something connected, so in this case, I have github.com already connected to my GitKraken client because I use the sign in with GitHub method. If you signed in with GitLab, you'll get automatically connected. If you signed in with Bitbucket, you'll get automatically connected. However, if you see that you are not connected, well, GitKraken Client provides you the steps to set up those integrations. In any case, I'm just going to jump ahead to my github.com tab here. And when you have the connection set up, what you get is a drop-down menu. So I'm going to search for merge conflict test. So there, this is the repository that I wish to clone down from my remotes. And you see like the steps are pretty simple, are pretty similar as well. Choose where it's going to be cloned to. You select the repo from a drop-down menu instead of entering a URL, and do confirm the name of the repository or the path. All right, so let's clone this repo. And all right, looks like it's been cloned. I'll open this repo as well. And this one has a much more active graph, as you can tell. All right, and that's how you clone a repo using the URL method or cloning with the integration. Definitely of the two, I recommend using the integrations if you can. They're just more convenient and they'll save you some time.